water has surface tension.
यमुना जो दूषित हुई है इंदिरा गांधी के मरने के बाद से हुई है।
ये कूड़ा देख सकते हो यहाँ पर यमुना नदी किनारे दूर तक कूड़ा काफी यहाँ पर नजर आ रहा है।
कलियुग में इनकी महिमा एक लुप्त होने जा रही है। इनकी सफाई के लिए जो भी नेता लोग आते हैं अपना पब्लिकों से हस्ताक्षर करा के चले जाते हैं और यहाँ तक कोई सफाई नहीं होता है।
बहुत ज्यादा मात्रा में हो गया है, बहुत कचरा उचरा हो रहा है।
Rivers have been the lifelines of our nation and of every nation in a way. We are a culture, a civilization which has grown out of a river bank. Northern India is dominated by the Himalayas. Snow melt from the high peaks flows into some of the most sacred rivers of Asia. One of the most sacred and oldest rivers of India is Yamuna.
शब्द जगत जननी जगदम्बा परम परमेश्वरी जन्म जन्मांतर से युगों युगों से मेरे पूर्वज वेद ब्रह्मांड को जानने वाले राजा भागरथ के वंशज में तमाम घनघोर कष्ट उठाए और सोचे कि इस पवित्र पावनी माँ गंगा जमुना कैसे धरती पे जाए। अनंत तप किए, उनके तप के बल से ये जगदम्बा जमुना माई इस धरती पे अवतरित हुई और सबको पवित्र मोक्ष दान करती हुई चली जा रही हैं। मोक्षदायिनी माँ चारों युगों से तीर्थ स्थान पितरों की पूजन होती है। इस कलियुग में इनकी महिमा एक लुप्त होने जा रही है।
Yamuna originates from Himalayas in Yamunotri glaciers at a height of 6,387 meters. This 1,376 kilometer long river flows slowly through India, crossing three states, Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, and one union territory, Delhi. River Yamuna supports over 50 million people and believed to be sacred by 1 billion Hindus. But what has happened over these years that it has now become India's dirtiest river?
Yamuna is a sacred river. It flows from Mussoorie to Allahabad. It's the biggest tributary of River Ganga. During independence, after independence, the water quality of Yamuna was very pure. People used to drink the water. But over the last 30 to 40 years, number of people have increased in the basin area. What we find now that the quality of river has degraded, very poor status. There is water deficit of around 35 BCM. Billion cubic meter. Also, the quality of water, especially in the belt of Delhi, is the worst, because we find that after doing lot of quality control, lot of testing, the biological oxygen demand has not decreasing, rather it is increasing very exponentially. We find that the eutrophication in the river has improved has increased, which is creating a lot of problems in the area. The main use of water from Yamuna is for bathing, is for irrigation, is in industries. The water that is generated or used at households or in industries is being reversed back into the Yamuna River, and the quality of water that is coming into the river is very poor, which has resulted the quality of water to not being drinkable. The river stretch for more than 1300 kilometers, and especially in the Delhi belt, where the river flows for only 2% of its total length, but finds that more than 60 to 70% of quality degradation of Yamuna River occurs in Delhi belt, especially from the Wazirabad barrage to the down one.
The damage is most stark after Wazirabad, just inside the Delhi borders, where the river meets a barrage and comes to a sudden halt. On the other side, a major drain dumps nearly 500 million gallons of sewage into the riverbed each day. Dissolved oxygen levels in the water drop from about 13 milligram per liter to zero.
Of Yamuna from Wazirabad to Okhla barrage is receiving huge amount of wastewater that is being generated from the households and the industries in the Delhi belt. This water is directly being dumped into the Yamuna River and is not being treated. We find that in Delhi, like more than 40% of water, wastewater that is coming into Yamuna is untreated, which is not being treated at all. And that is the main reason of the increasing biological oxygen demand in the river. The POD is not decreasing.
If we talk the causes of water pollution, the most important causes are the disposal of untreated human excreta, cattle excreta, industrial waste, which consists of a number of toxic chemicals, solid waste such as polythene, wrappers, and apart from all these, the dispersal of statues after festivals. The statues, they are decorated by different paints, and these paints are non-biodegradable, which are very, very harmful. It is harmful for aquatic life. It is harmful for irrigation purpose. This water, it cannot be used for drinking. This causes a number of diseases such as amoebosis, jaundice, typhoid, malaria, cholera. The list is endless.
The main cause of this situation is the wastewater, which is of worst quality in the world, I can say, coming into the river without any treatment. Over the period of time, the number of people who are living in Delhi has at least doubled. Their requirements of water has increased. The groundwater also, we find the water table of groundwater in the Delhi belt is depleting, is going down. In the coming time, if we don't do anything, then we'll find that the people who are living in Delhi or in the close vicinity of Yamuna River will move far away from the river, because we find that a lot of civilization do usually settle near the river.
यमुना आज से 84 में बिल्कुल साफ थी, पानी ऐसा था जो पी लिया करता था, आचमन करता था। अब ऐसा दूषित हो गई है यमुना कि हाथ या नहाने को भी मन नहीं करता इसमें। हर आदमी यमुना को छोड़ के हरिद्वार गंगा जी भाग रहा है। पब्लिक कम हो गई पहले से, अब कोई इतने आते नहीं हैं लोग। जैसे मावस पूरनमासी पे भीड़ हुआ करती थी, वो सब बंद हो गई, ख़त्म होती जा रही है। मेले लगते थे, बैसाखी का नहान होता था, उस पर लाखों पब्लिक आती थी, वो सब बंद हो गई। तो बस देखते ही लोग वापसी हो जाते हैं, छींटे भी नहीं लगाते, इतना दूषित हो गया।
Moving from Wazirabad barrage to the Okhla barrage, which is apparently the last stop of Yamuna River in Delhi, a bizarre sight can be seen where a thick layer of foam is spread all across the river.
Look at this white substance floating on the surface of water. It appears like snow, but I'm sorry to say, it is not snow. It is foam, which is formed due to pollutants present in water. As we all know, water has surface tension. When the pollutants, they decompose or they decay, they form some organic compounds which mixes with air and result in the formation of a small bubble, and they form clusters and which result in the formation of foam. Foam formation is a natural phenomenon. If the water is not polluted, if the water is clear, then foam automatically disappears because oxygen clears water. But if the water is polluted, the foam does not settle and it does not allow oxygen to react with it, and it remains unclean, unhealthy and polluted.
Although the Yamuna River is not navigable, it is of great economic importance to India. There are several canals on the Yamuna that irrigate large areas on both banks. Besides this, Yamuna also partly supplies the water for big Indian cities like Delhi or Agra. In last 23 years, over 2000 crore rupees have been spent on Yamuna cleanup projects. But has it really changed anything?
Government of India has decided to do something about the Yamuna River. They started thinking about doing something in the last 3 decades. In 80s, they came up with Yamuna Action Plan, the first one. And they did some planning that how we can stop the wastewater coming into the Yamuna, the quality or the improvement of the quality of water, what can be done about it, setting up sewage treatment plants, using water for some other regions or sourcing water for irrigation and industries from some other sources. But over a period of time, we find that nothing much has improved. A lot of money has been spent over the last 3 decades. The government has spent more than 2,000 crore rupees, but nothing much has changed all over the stretch of the river. What we see, what the people of Delhi or India see, is that the government is spending a lot of time and money in making plans, and there is no action on the ground. The quality of water has not improved. The water deficit is a huge problem. The control of wastewater treatment in the industries, or setting up in situ wastewater treatment in the industries, is not being followed, is not being implemented properly. And over a period of time, if you don't do anything, then we will find that the government actions will never be achieved.
As an individual, we can control water pollution by not throwing solid waste such as polythene and wrappers in water. The earlier said things also should not be disposed in water, such as automobile waste, industrial waste, and the statues should not be immersed in water.
पहले हम देखते थे कि सरकार ही सब कुछ करती थी, लेकिन अब ज़रूरत है लोगों को एक बदलाव लाने की अपने आदतों में। कैसे कि पहले हम देखते थे लोग जब पूजा के लिए यहाँ यमुना नदी के पास पूजा करने आते थे तो एक सामूहिक पूजा होती थी जिसमें एक मूर्ति हुआ करती थी भगवान की और उसका हम विसर्जन करते थे। पर आज की डेट में हम देखते हैं कि हर एक इंसान भगवान के साथ डायरेक्ट कनेक्ट होना चाहता है, सीधा अपने आप को भगवान से कनेक्ट करने के लिए अपनी एक मूर्ति इंडिविजुअली लेकर यहाँ पर आते हैं। जैसे हमें देखते हैं कि 100, 200, 500 मूर्तियाँ यहाँ पे विसर्जन के लिए आ जाती हैं, जिसकी वजह से हमारे यमुना की क्वालिटी, वाटर क्वालिटी बहुत ही ज़्यादा प्रदूषित हो रही है। तो इस तरीके के बदलावों को हमें पीछे जाने की ज़रूरत है, पुराने आदतों को वापस लाने की ज़रूरत है, जो शायद एक बदलाव ला सके।
राम घाट पर इतनी भारी मात्रा में गंदगी हो गई है, पहले पर्यटक और पर्यटक भी आते जाते रहते थे, मगर अब उनका भी आना कम हो गया है, ना के बराबर हो, क्योंकि नाव वाव भी नहीं चलेंगी तो पर्यटक कहाँ से आएंगे। और पहले सरकारी कर्मचारी भी आ जाते थे, अब उनका भी आना बंद हो गया है।
The condition may be worse than Agra and Mathura, where Yamuna is heavily polluted.
एक टाइम ऐसा था हम इसके पानी से खाना भी बनाते थे, पीते भी थे, और अब तो हाथ गिरने का भी मन नहीं करता है।
अगर हम अपनी पौराणिक कथाओं को पढ़ें तो हमें ज्ञात होगा कि ऐसा ही भयानक प्रदूषण एक बार कालिया नाग ने यमुना में किया था, जिसका दमन भगवान श्री कृष्ण ने किया था। फिर आज हम सब कालिया नाग क्यों बने हुए हैं?
नॉर्दर्न एशिया, द मिडल ईस्ट, मोस्ट ऑफ अफ्रीका, Northeast Mexico, the western states of America, Argentina, Chile, and most of continent Australia suffer from a lack of fresh water. And pollution is the major cause.